12:10 a.m. Lisa and Rodrigo are in the kitchen talking about Noreen.
Cheeky fucking girl. Because she's so fucking cocksure. I also want to say something.
Not tonight, because Charlie... If you say, it will be bad for Charlie. Then she will think, you know.
She can think what she fucking wants. Yeah. I so want to say, why are you talking like that?
David, B and Halfwit are at the bus stop.
I have a problem with authority. People don't listen to me at all. Like, I'll say, come on, guys, you know, it's quarter past. In fact, it's actually 20 past nine, guys. Like, ah, wasp again. Wasp keep on landing on me. Fucking it's awful, Fred.
Yeah.
I'll see you in the bedroom, guys, or in the...
All right, my man. I'll see you soon.
I mean, God, that's priceless.
Oh, dude.
Crazy, crazy night.
Oh, yeah, my man.
Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Having a slow night.
Nah, it's pissed off.
No, do you think he likes me?
Sleep on it. Take my word on this one. Sleep on it.
Noreen.
I'm gonna obviously give a shit.
Can I have a word, please?
Huh?
Can I have a word, please?
Yeah.
Did you say to somebody that, right, that Charlie was out next and that nobody likes Lisa on the outside because they're all in my clan or something, or in my group?
No.
You didn't say that.
No,
that
I didn't
at all.
Say that, because you can ask anyone. I said Charlie's going to win the show and I want Charlie to win because of his mom and stuff like that. I don't think you're pretty much liked in the outside because someone told me that already, but I didn't say that to anyone in this house apart from one person that told me. And someone's obviously making that up, saying that I said that. Because whatever you said, I still said I said, but in a different context, but I would never said it the way you said it, and I would have never said that by Charlie.
Well, it was said, yesterday was said that,
Shree, but who said it to you, first of all?
Shree went first. Then Chris, then Carly, and you're next, and you're going to be next with me being up for eviction. That was on my mind anyway, because I thought it was...
Was it you that said it, Charlie?
What?
Was it you that said it to Lisa?
I said about like you saying that I was going to go next.
I didn't say you... So you said that to Lisa?
But you thought I was going to go next, and I don't need that at the minute. It's since you said that, it's caused me to be a bit funny with Lisa, and I don't like that feeling. I don't feel it for anyone, and I've been close to you, and I don't want to feel that thought.
I don't care if the outside hate me, but I haven't done anything wrong. So where that's coming from, who's told you that?
I feel like I haven't been myself around her since that, because even today, I've seen her out sitting by herself, and that's not me. To see anyone sitting by herself, and I've just sat and I thought, oh, I'm not going to go.
So right. People are avoiding me? So the group? So people are avoiding me because people think that the group, the public hate me?
You leaving what's got that to do with Lisa? At least Lisa's clan kind of thing along
the lines. They're not my clan. I don't tell people what to do in here. We've just got on, but it's not that I'm telling people what to do, but I do not tell people who to pick, what to do. Everybody's got their own mind in doing that. That's not down to me.
Yeah, Lisa, they can say what they want.
Well, yeah, they can. But it's just, you know, I wish people would directly come to me.
OK, what did I say to you what Halfwit said to me today?
I don't know, what did Halfwit say to you today?
About Charlie.
What?
That he goes bitching around people's backs and goes into the dining room and bitches.
Yeah, but...
He fucking told her every single detail. Yeah, he sits there to me today and says to me, you know, Noreen, I'd never say anything to you about anything that you talk to me with me about because I'm friends with both groups of people.
Yeah, but that's...
He doesn't tell me fucking... Lisa says. And he even... Like, I even know she says things about me, like... Well, I should have listened to Freddie about it because he obviously has more brains than me.
AM. Charlie, Rodrigo and Marcus are in the garden talking about Tom.
No, I just think that it's starting to crack. But I said that the other day, you know, when he started, told Dave to fuck off the other day.
The niceness is something.
And I think a lot of the reason why he's angry, if you know, she's just like that, sort of with everyone, flirty and stuff like that. And then when he saw her out with me, just sitting out in the rain, that he realised how like good friends we are and that, and he didn't like it.
Most of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Breaking news.
Sebas died.
Broken neck.
Shut up. It's fine. I'm just keeping that over here. I don't want this bed anymore in here. I don't want to upset anybody in here. I don't want to upset your ex-boyfriend either. I don't want to upset my ex-boyfriend. Think about it if you're watching the show.
All in Marcus's bed with his friend. Okay, that's all from the house. Join me after 8 out of 10 cats when I'll be quizzing Kenneth with ex-celebrity BB housemate Terry Christian and psychologist Jeffrey Beattie, and we'll also find out exactly what Carly thinks of her boyfriend's behaviour. I'll see you all at 10:35.
Yeah, but last time, I had the token and I couldn't get anything for me. So I said to them, I'm going to get alcohol for me, 20 cans, and like Cuba's wine.
20?
Yeah, but that was a special token.
Are you alcoholic or something like that?
But I was meant like,
how much do you drink on the outside world?
I drink 10 cans, 10 pints a night, and I go out 3-4 times a week.
Anyway, the generous guy...
Maureen, you don't. That's not healthy, that. The generous... So you can drink 30 pints in a week?
Yeah.
That must cost at least 200 or 300 quid.
Yeah.
So you buy them in pubs?
What?
In pubs,
yeah.
Side of